I'm Brendan Shanahan of the National Hockey League's Department of Player Safety. Throughout the season, we will provide video examples of both legal hockey plays and illegal plays that rise to the level of supplemental discipline. We hope to give players, clubs, and fans a better feel for how the league views such plays. We work within the rules and interpretations of the NHL rulebook. Our mandate is not necessarily to judge if an infraction is a penalty, but to determine the degree, and then decide whether additional discipline may be required. Although no two plays are ever exactly alike, these examples should serve as reference points and guidelines for similar plays. These videos will be available for all to view on NHL.com. The following are examples of legal hip checks where a player makes contact with his opponent above the knee.
Anthony Stewart ran into Yemelin and found out what everybody else is finding out.
The fast-growing reputation of Alexi Yemelin grows a little bit more with this hip check on Anthony Stewart.
We'll climb the center. Lost the puck, though, to Bergeron. Look out here. Oh, what a hit! Brian Campbell with a super check on Marchand.
You talk about being the aggressor and someone retaliating. I mean, Campbell with the perfect hit against Marchand. Old-fashioned hip check. You can't play it any better than that.
Now Anderson out of the goal, but Phaneuf is onto the puck. Phaneuf is upended there by Foligno.
You almost knew something might happen here. Phaneuf had Spezza, who's the best player for the Senators, and was pushing and shoving him just before the whistle and the commercial break. And Foligno was on the ice. He chatted to him a bit, and now he gives Phaneuf a pretty good ride.
The following is an example of a clipping infraction where a player delivers a check at or below his opponent's knee, which makes the contact dangerous and illegal. The distinction lies in the point of contact.
Henrik Sedin across to Edler to Henrik. Henrik's intentional slap pass, and now right across the goal line as Edler slips it through. Quick collision on the near side boards.
And then when this puck was up for grabs along the wall, Marchand's going to knock down Salow with that low hit.
The distinction between these two checks occurs at the point of contact. While Foligno makes contact with Phaneuf's pants, Marchand drops down dangerously low and makes contact with Salow's knees, which results in this check being a violation of the clipping rule. We hope this helps you better understand how the Department of Player Safety views and evaluates hip checks and clipping.